And what I want everybody to do, you can take your focus off the light for a second. And we're going to have everybody kind of lean to your right. So everybody lean to the right and put your head on the shoulder of the person sitting next to you. There we go. All right, everybody sit up nice and straight. Now we're going to lean to the left. So everybody go ahead and lean over to the left. Put your head on the shoulder of the person next to you. Perfect. And everybody go ahead and sit up nice and straight again. All right. So again, this is just a way when your body needs to get relaxed. Now you know when your body's relaxed. If you need a pillow, you can use the person sitting next to you. All right. So one more time, go ahead and look at that wall in the back that's sticking out. Lift your eyes up. Watch the light. And we're going to take three deep breaths together. And again, we're going to relax your bodies first, then we'll relax your minds. I'm going to just put on a little bit of music in the background to help you relax. So go ahead and everybody take a nice deep breath in. Perfect. And let it out. Take an even deeper breath in. And let it out. And then take the deepest breath yet. This time as you let it out, just slowly close your eyes. And let every word I say relax you just a little bit more. And during this process, which usually takes about 5-6 minutes, this is the only part, if you could be as quiet as you can, just so they can listen to my voice and focus on what I tell them to do. After we get through this part, the more you laugh, the more you cheer, the more noise that you make in the audience, the further into their imaginations they'll go. All right, so people on stage, to relax your bodies, we're going to start out using your power of focus. So what I want you to do is put all your attention, all your focus on your chair. If you're on the stage, put your focus on the stage. But those of you in chairs, focus on your chair and notice how it fully supports you. I'm sure you weren't thinking about your chair until I mentioned it, but you see how quickly you can put all your focus, all your attention on a single thing just by me mentioning it. All right, let's go to your right hand. Let your right hand sit nicely, comfortably on your lap. Again, you can see how quickly you can jump your focus from one thing to another with just a simple suggestion as you take all your focus now from your right hand over to your left hand. And again, you probably weren't thinking about it before, but as soon as I mention it and ask you to, you see how strong your focus can jump from one thing to the next. Go ahead and take all your focus down to your left foot. How it sits comfortably on the floor, nothing you need to do, but sit there and allow your body to relax. All right, one final thing we're going to do, all your focus, all your attention, take them up to your eyelids. Now you came up here because I'm sure you've done well on the test. You've shown you have a good ability to focus, you have a good imagination, you can follow suggestion. And I want you to put those all together again, and I want you to imagine that you can relax your eyelids so much that they're not going to open. You can actually get them so relaxed that they're just not going to open. Use your ability to imagine, your ability to focus. Use that power of suggestion and your intelligence to believe that your eyes are now so relaxed that they're not going to open. And I want you to prove it to yourself. So I'm going to count to three, and when I get to three, I want you to try to open your eyelids, but you're going to see, because of your imagination, your focus, and your intelligence, that you could actually keep them from opening and keep them so relaxed. As you try on one, two, and three, everybody's doing a great job. You can quit trying. Everybody's doing a great job. Now, that relaxation that you now have in your eyelids, we're going to send down your entire body. We're going to start at the top of your head. It's going to go like a wave down to the tips of your toes. So all that relaxation from your eyelids, go ahead and take it up to the top of your head. And we're going to slowly bring that relaxation down your body from the top of your head to your cheeks, from your cheeks to your chin. As that relaxation goes down your body, as it gets down to your neck, your head's going to start to feel heavy. And your head's slowly going to fall forward on one, two, and three, getting more and more relaxed. So it goes from your neck down to your chest, from your chest to your stomach to your thighs, allowing every muscle to relax from your knee to your calves, down to your ankles, all the way to the tips of your toes. Now I'm going to come around, I'm going to go down the line, and I'm just going to tell you to relax. And when I do that, I want you to imagine, it's almost like a bolt of lightning or energy going through your entire body that's going to relax every muscle in your body more than you've ever been relaxed before. You might become almost like a wet spaghetti noodle. So when I touch you on the shoulder, when I say relax, just allow every muscle in your body to completely relax as we get on the line. And go ahead and relax. 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 Relax. Go ahead and 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 relax. Just don't fall off. Don't fall off. People up front, you can lay back, just watch your head as you go ahead and relax. Go ahead and relax. Just watch your head. Go ahead and relax. Watch your head. Go ahead and relax. Watch your head. And go ahead and relax. Loud, the louder they cheer. Further into your imagination you'll go, the more relaxed you'll become. So on the count of three, everybody out there, give them a nice big round of applause. One, two, and three. Just allow that to relax you more, taking further and deeper into your imagination. All right, everybody keep your eyes closed, but I want you to sit up nice and straight. It's been a long school year. I earned a trip. We're all going to take a quick trip to Hawaii. And on the count of three, what I want you to do, keep your eyes closed, but I want you to get in a more comfortable position on the count of three. Here we go. One, two, and three. Imagine you're in a lounge chair. We're on a beach in Hawaii. It's a beautiful day. It's 70 degrees out. On the count of three, I want you to get even a more comfortable position on this lounge chair. One, two, and three. As comfortable as you can get. Now, they say in Hawaii that the hula dance tells a story with your hands. So I want you all to lift your hands up and show them the waves across, going across the ocean. Show them the waves going across the ocean. Great job. Lift your hands up. Show them the setting sun. Show them the setting sun. Perfect. Use your hands. Show them the beautiful girls in the bikinis. Show them the beautiful girls in the bikinis. Perfect. Now, as you're sitting there, the weather's starting to get warmer. It's just gone from 75 to 80 degrees. It's just gone from 80 to 85. You find if you put your hand up and you start to fan yourself, it actually cools you off. As it goes from 85 to 90, 90 to 95, use both hands. The more you fan, the better you feel. The more you fan, the better you feel. As we go from 95 all the way up to 100 degrees, the more you fan, the better you feel. And somebody has just turned some air conditioners on. Take a nice deep breath in. Let that relax you. Let that relax you. Everybody sit up nice and straight again. You're all doing a great job. We're going to get into some really fun stuff now. So go ahead, open your eyes. You're going to see me here on stage. Open your eyes. Looking all the way down the line. Let yourself go ahead and sleep, 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 sleep. All right, what we're going to do next, we're actually in a contest, and we're going to do a battle of the bands, and it's actually a battle of the symphonies. So we're going to do some symphony stuff. Just the guy I'm touching now, if you could keep your eyes closed, I'm going to give you some drumsticks. You're going to be one of our drummers. This girl right here, if you could put your hands up, you're going to be one of our drummers. I'm going to give you some drumsticks. And right down here on the end, if you could hold your hand up, I'm going to give you some drumsticks. You're going to be a drummer. All right, so we got three drummers. Everybody else, you can play keyboard, you can play the trumpet, the trombone, the tuba, anything you want. So everybody, this last time we're going to keep our eyes closed, but if everybody could grab their instruments. And I can tell you, this is a contest, and whoever wins this contest is going to win a brand new car. So everybody has a chance to win a brand new car. You don't want to let your friends down. You don't want to let the other people in the band down. So grab your instruments. The judges are out here. They're ready to judge you. And we're going to try and win this brand new car together. So here we go. Perfect. Everybody's doing good. The judges are watching. Job. All right, the three drummers, if you're a drummer, just the drummers, stand up. Drummers, stand up. Just the drummers. All right, this is for the brand new car drummers. We're going to have you do a drum solo, so just the drummers, bring it home. A big ending. How about a big round of applause for our symphony? Drummers, you can have a seat. Everybody can open their eyes. Drummers, have a seat. Drummers, have a seat. Everybody open their eyes. I got great news. The judges, they all loved you. You just won the brand new car. So everybody's going to get brand new car. Watch me right up here. We're going to go ahead and sleep, 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 sleep. All right, since y'all just want a brand new car, we're going to take this thing out for a ride. We can't wait to show this off to all your family, all your friends. You've been working so hard. Everybody sit up nice and straight. Everybody sit up nice and straight. Keep your eyes closed. And we're going to start this thing up. Go ahead and put the key in. Go ahead and start the car up. All right, everybody go ahead and put your seatbelts on. All right, go ahead, everybody. Go ahead and pull out. And go ahead and hit the radio. Let's see what's on. Perfect. All right, you're going down. We want to show this to all your family and friends. Go ahead and take a selfie. Perfect. If you look out the left-hand side, you see one of your friends, go ahead and give them a wave. Let them see this new car. Perfect. Go ahead and look out the right-hand side. See one of your friends, go ahead and give them a wave. Perfect. All right, we actually want to see how fast this brand new car can go to take it to 40 to 45, 45 to 50. Oh, we got a speed bump on the count of three. One, two, and three. Perfect. Take it to 50 to 55. 55 to 60. 65 to 70. 75 to 80. Let's see if we can get all the way up to 100. 80 to 85. 85 to 90. 90 to 95. Go ahead. Really hit it. See if you can get it the whole way up there. All right. Everybody pull over. Everybody pull over. Pull over. Now, this officer just caught you driving 100 miles per hour in your brand new car, but I have good news for everybody. This officer has made a deal, and he said if you can tell him an excuse why you're driving 100 miles per hour that he's never heard before. So if you can be creative and tell him an excuse he's never heard before, he's not going to give you a ticket. So we're going to get on the line. This could get you in a lot of trouble. This could make you lose your license, maybe even go to jail. So come up with a good excuse. This person, I'm touching now. Why were you going 100 miles an hour?
My mom died.
Your mom died? Okay. How about right here? What were you going so fast for?
Speedy.
Speedy? Okay. How about right here?
It's a cool car.
Okay. How about right here?
I left my wig at home.
You left your wig at home? How about right here? What were you going so fast
my
for?
My cat died.
Your cat died? How about right here?
My puppy ate my toe.
Your puppy ate your toe? Okay. How about right here?
My goat had a kid.
Your goat had a kid? Okay. How about right here?
My fish was drowning.
Your fish was drowning? Okay. How about right here?
I was rescuing an endangered animal.
You're rescuing an endangered animal? Okay. How about right here?
I'm going to explode.
You're going to explode? Okay. How about right here?
The chickens are out.
Chickens are out. How about right here? What were you going so fast for?
My cat was barking.
Okay. And how about right here? What were you going so fast for?
My buffalo's at home.
Okay. And how about right here? What were you driving so fast for?
My turkey hit my sister in the head.
And how about right here? What were you going so fast for?
My dog exploded.
Dog exploded. How about right here? What were you going so fast for?
New car, new wheels. I'm gonna go.
Gotcha. And how about right here? What were you going so fast
for? My aardvark choked on a marble statue.
And I got good news. The officer loved all your excuses. Nobody's going to get a ticket. Everybody take a nice deep breath in. Take a nice deep breath in. Go ahead, everybody open your eyes. Open your eyes. Find me here on stage. Let yourself go to the deep breath.
Sleep, sleep, sleep,
sleep, sleep, sleep, sleep, sleep, sleep, sleep, sleep, sleep, sleep. At a moment, just the person I'm touching now, just the person I'm touching on the shoulder, keep your eyes closed. In a moment, I have you wake up, and you're going to find something really strange has happened. You're going to find that you can no longer remember the number six. So no matter how hard you try, go ahead and sleep. Let yourself relax. No matter how hard you try, you won't be able to remember the number six. So when you count, you're going to count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and so on. If you count backwards, it'll be 10, 9, 8, 7, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And until I snap my fingers, you're not going to be able to remember the number six. Do you understand that? Nod your head, yes. Everybody else on stage, in a moment you're going to see me interviewing a girl on stage. And that girl, you're going to realize she can't remember the number six. And every time she forgets to say the number six, you're going to think it's one of the funniest things you've ever seen in your life. If you all understand that, nod your head, yes. Perfect. Everybody go ahead and sit up nice and straight. Everybody sit up nice and straight. You can all open your eyes now. You can all open your eyes. And thanks for all volunteering, participating. I love to find out about people who volunteered for a show. So did you mind if I interview you? Come on up here. Let me turn this on. What's your name?
Grace.
Grace. And you're graduating this year?
Yeah.
What are you going to do after high school?
Go to Clemson.
Clemson, nice. Congratulations. Yeah. Down in South Carolina?
Yeah.
Yeah, nice weather too, huh?
Yeah.
All right. So have you always gone to Bellefonte? Here?
Yeah.
Okay. And so you've been learning for a long time. So let me ask you this. Total number, how many fingers do you have?
10.
10, and how many toes do you have?
10.
Okay, so we're going to try that out. I want you to put your two hands out like this, and we're going to go one at a time, and you're going to count them. So we'll start with the number 1, and we'll go all the way up to the number 10, okay?
Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11.
Oh, wait a second. I thought you said you had 10 fingers. Let's try again. Go ahead and put them up. Maybe I went too fast. Just put your hands out. Now let's not joke around. You know, how many fingers do you have?
10.
Yeah, you know you have 10, right? And how many toes do you have?
10.
10, right. So let's do this again. Ready?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Seven, eight, 9, 10, 11.
Oh, wait. Did you like grow an extra finger or? You not sure?
I don't know.
Well, let's try one more. Put your hands out. Let's go backwards this time. We'll start with the number 10 and we'll get down. You know you have 10 fingers, right? Yeah, you've always had 10. So we'll start with the number 10 and we'll get down to the number 1. Okay? Here we go.
10, 9, 8, 7, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
All right. Go ahead, watch my fingers. When I snap, the number 6 is going to come back. 1, 2, 3. Just count 1 to 10 for us.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
There we go. Give her a big round of applause. You guys, come on over here. Go ahead and have a seat. Go ahead and have a seat. I'm going to move this out of the way. And go ahead and watch me right here. Go ahead and sleep. In a moment, we're going to wake you all back up. This time when we wake you up, anytime you hear me say the word bad, if you hear me say the word bad, you're going to smell the worst smell you've ever smelled in your life. And you're going to be 100% convinced that that smell is coming from the person sitting next to you. Now, this smell is so bad that you're not going to be embarrassed. You're not going to be afraid to tell us exactly who it is that smells and exactly what that smell smells like. Now, that smell's not going to make you sick. It's not going to make you sick, but it is going to be disgusting. And you're going to be so upset about it that you're going to be ready to tell us exactly what it is that stinks, who stinks, and what they stink like. If you all understand, only when I say the word bad, so listen for me to say bad. If you all understand that, nod your head yes. Perfect. Everybody go ahead and sit up nice and straight. And you can all open your eyes. So one of the things that I've noticed since, you know, a lot of people use texting now and video games have become more popular and they get locked in. People are hypnotizing themselves so often these days that hypnosis shows are pretty easy. It's been a while since I've had a bad show. I haven't had a bad show in quite a while, and I can have the... Wait, I... Let me see. Come back down here. What are you smelling over here?
But Dussie.
And what's it smell like?
But Dussie.
And how about right here? What are you smelling?
That's brunch. What did you eat?
And how about right here? What are you smelling?
Rotting trash panda.
And where is it coming from?
That one.
And what are you smelling?
I smell like poop. It's coming from home.
And how about right here? What are you smelling?
I'm smelling like a whole trash can that's on fire and it's coming from somewhere.
And how about right here? What are you smelling?
He smells like straight booty cheeks.
How about here? What do you smell?
Poop.
Shit.
Oh, coming from where? Right there. And what are you smelling?
Skunk.
Coming from where? Right here. How about right here? What do you smell?
Rotten eggs.
Coming from right over here. What do you smell?
Dirty softball jerseys.
And how about right here?
So much sweat.
Coming from where? Right there. And how about here? What are you smelling?
Roadkill.
Coming from where? In this area. And what about you? What do you smell?
Wet dog poop.
Coming from who? Right there. Okay. All right. On the count of three, the smell's going to be gone. Everybody take a nice deep breath in. Let it relax you on 1, 2, and 3. Everybody, nice deep breath in. Let's get everybody back in their chairs. I'm actually going to bring you down this way. I'm going to have you switch with this girl right here. So if you want to have a seat right there, and then I'll have you take this seat right. Actually, you go in this one over there. Yeah, you two switch, and then you take that one right there. Perfect. Everybody look at me. Go ahead. All the way down the line. Yourself. Sleep, 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 sleep. All right, we're going to use a couple of the people down this direction. So just the girl I'm touching right now, keep your eyes closed. In a moment, when you wake up, you're going to find something really strange has happened. You're going to realize that you can no longer remember your last name. So you remember your first name, you'll remember your middle name, but no matter how hard you try, until I snap my fingers, you won't be able to remember your last name. Do you understand that? Nod your head yes. This guy right here, keep your eyes closed. In a moment, I'm going to wake you back up. You're going to be 100% convinced that your name is Cha-Cha. So you're going to tell me your first name's Cha-Cha, your middle name's Cha-Cha, your last name's Cha-Cha. The more I ask you about your name, the more annoyed you're going to get with me that I keep asking about it. But your first name, your middle name, and your last name is going to be Cha-Cha. If you understand that, nod your head yes. Perfect. Everybody go ahead and sit up nice and straight. All right, we're going to continue on with some interviews. Again, I love learning about people who volunteer in my show. Go ahead, everybody can open their eyes. And let's see, do you mind if I interview you? Come on up here. This guy, can I interview you? Come on up here. We'll put you, doesn't matter what side. We'll just put one on each side. I'll start with you. What's your first name?
Claire.
Claire, you're a senior as well. What are you going to do after high school here?
Nursing.
Okay, nice. So, Claire, what's your middle name?
Jane.
And your last name is? Sometimes, let's kind of get a little pattern going here. Your first name is?
Claire.
Your middle name is?
Jane.
And your last name is?
Claire Jane.
Claire Jane? Okay, keep thinking about it. What's your first name?
Cha-Cha.
Cha-Cha. And what's your middle name?
Cha-Cha.
Cha-Cha, and your last name is?
Cha-Cha.
So wait, your first name is?
Cha-Cha.
Your middle name is?
Cha-Cha.
Your last?
Cha-Cha.
Okay, and how about you? Do you remember your first name?
Claire.
Claire, and your middle name?
Jane.
And your last name?
Claire Jane.
Claire Jane. Claire Jane. So your first name's Claire, your middle name's Jane, and your last name's Claire Jane? Mm-mm. No. You know what? It's weird. It's actually like written on the tip of your tongue. If you stick your tongue out, you can actually see it. What was your first name?
It's Cha-Cha, I told you.
And your middle name is?
It's Cha-Cha. It's Cha-Cha, I told you already.
Oh, wait a second. So Cha-Cha, is that like a family name or where'd that come from?
I don't know. It's Cha-Cha.
How do you spell that?
C-H-A-C-H-A.
Okay. Both C's capitalized or just one?
Both of them. Why would they both not be capitalized?
Hyphen in the middle or no?
Yes.
Okay, sounds good. And your first name was?
Claire.
And your middle name is?
Jane.
And your last name is? You didn't see it on your tongue? Yeah. The girl in the Navy, what is her last name? Janskrat? Did I say that right? Okay. Did you hear what she just said? Okay. What's your first name?
Claire.
Your middle name?
Jane.
Your last name? Watch when I snap my fingers, your name comes back. One, two, three. Just what's your first name?
Claire.
Middle name?
Jane.
Last name?
Janskrat.
Perfect. You can give her a round of applause. You can have a seat. And what was your name again?
It's Cha-Cha. Stop asking.
We're going to keep you Cha-Cha. Cha-Cha, you can go back to your seat. Perfect. We'll use you a little bit later again. All the way down the line. Go ahead. Sleep, 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 sleep. Alright. In a moment we're gonna wake you all back up. This time when you wake up, you're gonna find that you're a contestant on a game show. And you're a contestant on a game show, you're trying to win the big prize. So after you wake up and you realize that you're on the game show, I'll be the host. I'll tell you exactly what game we're playing today and how you can win the grand prize. So you're going to be excited, you're going to be happy, and you're going to want to win this prize. If you all understand that, nod your head yes. Perfect. Everybody go ahead and sit up nice and straight. Go ahead and open your eyes. Welcome to our game show. This is for a big prize that we're giving away today, and we got something special. Your city decided that it's going to put a brand new statue in the center of town. And so this game show, we got a bunch of judges out there from your hometown, and they're going to judge you on who can come up with the best statue. So you're going to give them the Everybody can go ahead and stand up. Let's start out with that. Go ahead and stand up and spread yourselves out. Make sure you got plenty of room between each one. And so what's going to happen is I'm going to count to three, and once I get to three, you're going to give a demonstration of exactly what your statue looks like to everybody. So here's the thing. It's got to be original. It's got to be creative. Facial expressions, I'm sure, are going to mean a lot to the judges. And I want, as you get into your statue, I want you to come up with a creative name so we can know exactly what your statue is and what it represents. So everybody, you're going to get in your statue pose on one, two, and three. Go ahead, show everybody your statue. Show everybody your statue. And we're going to come down the line. We want to see what some of these statues are, what they represent. So just the person right here, what's the name of your statue?
Cucullin, Irish Hercules.
Irish Hercules, perfect. This person right here, what's the name of yours? Perfect. How about right here? What's the name of your statue?
Super.
Super. And this guy down here, what's your statue?
The Dead Frog.
The Dead Frog. Okay. How about right here? What's the name of yours?
Muscles.
Muscles. Perfect. How about right here?
Smelton Delton.
Okay. Smelton Delton. How about right here? What's the name of yours?
My animations are broke. Please help me.
Okay. How about right here? What's the name of yours?
That guy.
That guy. How about right here? What's the name of yours?
Bear.
Bear. Perfect. How about right here? What's yours?
Rice Farmer.
Rice Farmer. How about right here?
I lost my leg.
You lost your leg? How about right here?
Maria Cotter, two-peat Powder Puff football champion.
Yeah! How about right here?
Balance.
Balance, nice. How about right here?
Mew.
Mew, perfect. How about right here?
The Red Dancer.
Okay, and how about right here?
Power Couple.
Power Couple, and how about right here?
The Wagger.
The Wagger. We're going to let the girl in the red, I'm going to let you pick the winner. Who do you think got the best statue of? Which one's right here?
Yeah.
All right, perfect. Everybody did a great job. Give them all a round of applause. You stay up here, though. Everybody go ahead and return to your seats. You're going to stay up here. Everybody else go ahead back to your seats. Everybody's going to get a little piece of this prize. So what's your name?
Caitlin Packer.
Caitlin. Okay, so Caitlin, what I'm going to do is I'm going to give Caitlin a bunch of hypnosis dust. So go ahead and hold your hand out. And I'm going to give you some. And what this hypnosis does is when it hits somebody in the head, it knocks them right back into the world of hypnosis. So for example, if I use cha-cha, watch, if I just take a little bit of this, if I hit them in the head, watch how it knocks them right out. Perfect. So I'm going to let you go right down the line. Go ahead and start on the end. Just get a little pinch of dust and go right down the line and go ahead and hit everybody, knock them right back into the world of hypnosis. Perfect. And you can go ahead and have a seat. You did a great job. All right, everybody go ahead and sit up and go ahead back into your seats. Go ahead back into your seats. Glad you're all getting so relaxed. And what we're going to do next is, you can all open your eyes. What we're going to do next, we're actually going to have what's called the World's Worst Dance Contest. Now, this isn't for good dancers, because if you're a good dancer, it's kind of hard to dance badly. But the winner of this contest is going to be the person who can do the absolute worst dance. Now, we don't have quite enough room for everybody, so I'm only going to give a few tickets away. But if you would like a ticket to be in the World's Worst Dance Contest, raise your hand. Who would all like a ticket? All right, so I'm going to give you a ticket right here. I'm going to give you a ticket. We're coming back to Cha-Cha, don't worry. Go ahead, we're going to give you a ticket and you a ticket as well. All right, so everybody, if you got a ticket, go ahead and stand up. Take a couple steps forward, spread yourselves out. And I think we got get the props ready. All right, so when you hear the music play, we want to see your absolute worst dance. The audience will be our judges. At the end, they'll cheer for who did the absolute worst dance. Just watch the edge of the stage. Don't go near the edge of the stage. And here we go. We'll be right back. find a winner, I'm going to move this back out of the way. And so I'll come down the line. You cheer for who you thought was the absolute worst dancer. I thought you did you're a pretty good dancer, apparently, so that's all right. How about right here? How about right here? Okay, and down here on the end. All right, so I think you got the winner as the worst dancer, so everybody else have a seat. You're going to get the prize. Come on up here. You're going to get the prize, and I'm going to have, let's see if we can pull this chair back in, and then I'm going to have everybody slide down one. Everybody from here, you stay right where you're at. You slide down one, and then what I want you to do is hold your finger up like this. And what if you all watch, what I'm going to do is all the power of hypnosis that I have, I'm going to put in this guy's finger. And as it goes into his finger, anytime he comes around, it just gives you a little touch on the forehead. As soon as he touches you on the forehead, it's going to knock you into that world of hypnosis. So go ahead right down there. Not too hard, just a little tap on each person's forehead should knock them out, making them feel good, relaxed, and back into the world of hypnosis. All right, now come on over here. I'm going to have you come back. Let's see. Just first, I'm touching now. Go ahead and sit up nice and straight. Just first, I'm touching here. Go ahead and sit up nice and straight. I'm going to bring you back here. Go ahead and have a seat here. And go ahead and hold that finger up. And take this hand, put it on your wrist, turn it this way. And I want you to stare at your finger. Put your hand there. And you're going to try and stop. And as you stare at that finger, you know the power that it has in it. It's slowly going to move towards your forehead. And you're going to try and stop it, but you find the more you try and stop it, the closer and closer it gets to your forehead. The more you try and stop, and you know what it's going to do. As soon as it hits you, it knocks you right into the world of hypnosis. All right, just press some touch now. Go ahead. Relax. This first I'm touching now. In a moment, cha-cha, I'm going to wake you back up. When you wake up, you're going to find me standing on the stage, and with me is going to be the most beautiful girl you've ever seen in your entire life. You can't believe how attractive this girl is. And she's told me she thinks you're an attractive guy, and she hopes that you ask her to dance. If you have a good pickup line, you can use that pickup line. If you don't have a good pickup line, it's okay, because she's already told me she likes you, and she wants you to ask her to dance. So you'll just either use your pickup line or just ask her to dance. And like I said, it's going to be the most beautiful girl you've ever seen in your life. You understand that? Nod your head yes. Perfect. All right, everybody just stay right where they're at for a second. Everybody can sit up nice and straight. Go ahead and open your eyes. Another big cheer for Cha-Cha! Cha-Cha, did you catch her name?
I think it was Linda, I'm not sure.
Linda, would you like to keep Linda with you?
Yes.
All right, perfect. Go ahead and take Linda back. And what I want you all to do is imagine that I'm holding a boomerang. And this isn't just an ordinary boomerang, this is a hypnotic boomerang. And I'm going to throw this boomerang, and you're going to see it go down the sidewall. You're going to see it fly across the back wall. You'll see it fly across this sidewall. It's going to fly back up here, and it's going to hit you on the head. And it's not going to hurt you, though, when it hits you on the head. It's going to knock you right back into the world of imagination and hypnosis. So go ahead and watch. See it go down that sidewall. See it go across the back wall. See it come up this sidewall. Here it comes. As soon as it hits you on the head, let it knock you right down into the world of hypnosis. Nice and relaxed. All right, so we're going to try, let's try a couple people we haven't used. Just this girl I'm touching right here. Keep your eyes closed. Just the person I'm touching now. When I wake you up, you're going to find that you're a finalist in a national spelling bee. And that it's for a nice big college scholarship, so something you've been working hard at. You've been studying all kinds of spelling words to be able to win this contest. But you're nervous. So one of the things that you notice is anytime you get a word that has a letter S in it, if you get a word with the letter S, when you try and say the letter S, you're going to find that your tongue swells up to like 10 times its regular size. And you just can't get out the letter S. If you understand that, nod your head yes. Perfect. And this guy right here, just the one that I'm touching, in a moment you're going to find out you're the other finalist in the National Spelling Bee. You are also been working hard, you're a little bit nervous. So anytime you get a word with the letter S, when you get to the letter S, before you can say the letter S, you kind of have like a nervous tick, and you slap yourself across the face before you can say the letter S. Do you understand that? Nod your head, yes. Perfect. Everybody else, go ahead and sit up nice and straight. All right, we're going to finish off the National Spelling Bee. You've all been working so hard. These are all our finalists, but we are down to our final two. So I believe, this girl right here, you're one of our finalists for the spelling bee. Come on up here. And who's our, you're one of the finalists too. Come on up here. And well, let's start out here. What's your name?
Liz.
Liz, and you're a senior?
Mm-hmm.
And what are you going to do after high school here?
Going to go to college.
Okay, and so this scholarship would help you out a lot?
Yeah.
Okay, so let's give you your first name, or your first word. How about dog?
D-O-G.
That's it. Give her a big round of applause. Sounds good. Your other finalist, what's your name?
Brady.
Brady, what are you going to do after high school?
Go to Penn State.
Penn State, nice. So this scholarship would help you a lot too, I'm sure. All right, so let's do your first word, cat.
C-A-T.
That's it. Give him a huge round of applause. Let's come over here. How about the word gas?
G-A.
Let's try a little bit fast. Let's start with letter G and then go ahead.
G-A.
Can you kind of do it with your finger? S? I think that's it. Give her a round of applause. All right, so you got to keep tied with her. How about the word chase?
C-H-A.
S-E.
There we go. Give him a round of applause. Good job. All right, I think we're getting down there. How about the word grass?
G-R-A.
I think if you can get grass, it's going to be all yours. Go for it.
G-R-A-S.
That's it. Here's our winner. Give him a huge round of applause. You did a great job. You'll get an award, too, for second place. Go ahead and have a seat there. Go ahead a second. Did you ever finally get her name?
It's Linda. She it told Linda. Me, yeah.
So are you guys going to do something later?
I'm going to take her home tonight, yeah.
All the way down the line. Sleep, 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 sleep. All right, as we're getting towards the end here, what I want you to do now is when I wake you all up, you're going to find this one of my favorite things to do, that you're all world-famous rappers. But you don't rap ordinary songs. You actually rap your favorite children's songs. So the ABCs, Twinkle Twinkle Little Star, all those kind of songs that you loved as little boys and girls. People from all over the world come to listen to you rap their favorite children's song. If you all understand that, nod your head yes. Perfect, everybody sit up nice and straight. And I'm going to put a little beat on the background. These are our famous rappers from around the world. You got a huge audience out here. They want to hear their favorite children's song. So I'll put on some music in the background. When you got it ready, just raise your hand and I'll bring you the mic.
Twinkle, twinkle, little star. Oh, I forgot it. I'm bombing out here.
That's all right. Give him a round of applause. We like the beginning of it. Who else got their favorite children's song ready to go? Let's hear what you got.
Row, row, row your boat gently down the stream. Merrily, 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 I forget the rest of the words. Yeah!
Awesome job. Give them a big round of applause. All right, who else got their song all ready to go? What you got?
Oh. A, B, C, D, E, F, and G. Yo. I don't know what comes after G. I'm a G. I tell you what.
Give them a big round of applause. You did an awesome job. Thank you so much. Got time for two or three more. Who else would like to go? Well, we'll end with Cha-Cha. Well, we're going to end with you. Anybody else want to go before Cha-Cha? All right, here, you want to give it a shot? Go for it.
Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. Something, something, twinkle, twinkle, star.
Give her a big round of applause. That was awesome. Great job. I'm ready to go ahead. Let's see what you got.
On the bus go round and round, round and round, round and round. The wheels on the bus go round and round, all through the town.
Awesome job. Give her a huge round of applause. Alright, Cha-Cha, you can take Linda up there with you. Bring us home.
Mary had a little lamb, little lamb, little lamb. Mary had a little lamb and he was white as snow.
How about a huge round of applause for Cha-Cha? Cha-Cha, that was awesome. Thank you so much. Everybody else, go ahead, look up here. Me on stage, right down the line. Go ahead and sleep, 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 and sleep. All right, what we're going to do is we're going to slowly bring you out of the state back into the room, back into the world. So what I want you to do, you're not used to being able to have control and speak over this part of your brain. So I know a lot of you have some plans going into the workforce, going off to college. And so this is your opportunity while I'm continuing to talk and while you're walking up the same stairs that we started going down, that when you're going up the stairs, what I want you to imagine is whatever it is that you plan to do after high school, I want you to see yourself being successful at that. So if you're going off to college, see yourself working hard, studying hard, you know, nailing that major and doing super awesome in your classes. You know, if you still got some sports left for the rest of this year, you know, see yourself doing well at your district track meet, state meet, you know, baseball, softball games that you still have coming up, and, you know, see yourself being successful in those things. If there's a bad habit that you want to kick, just see yourself being able to overcome that habit. And so what I want you to do, I want you to imagine you're at the bottom of that five-step staircase. And just like we walked down it at the beginning, now we're going to walk up it. And when we get to the top, all the hypnosis, all the suggestions that we've done is going to be gone except for two. The first one, Cha-Cha, Cha-Cha right here. When you wake up, you're still going to believe that your name is Cha-Cha. So as long as you're in this room, as long as you're in the auditorium, if anybody asks you what your name is, you're still going to be 100% convinced that your name is Cha-Cha until you walk out of this room. As soon as you walk out of the room, you'll go back to whatever your name is. And everybody else on the stage, while you're in the auditorium, anytime you hear somebody say, Mike Lee, that's my name. When you hear Mike Lee, right away, you're just going to respond with, he's the man. So anytime you hear Mike Lee, you're just going to say, he's the man. Everything else with the missing names, the smells, the numbers will be completely gone. You'll be refreshed. You'll be relaxed. Again, you all did a great job showing your personalities up here and making people laugh and have a good time and making their senior night a special event, so you'll be very proud of yourself for coming up here and being brave enough and showing your personalities. All right, so see yourself at the bottom step. Go ahead and take up step number one. And slowly you can see the numbers starting to appear back on the steps again. As you slowly start to sit up nice and straight and go up step number two, the numbers are continuing to come back. And see from step two going up to step number three. Everybody take a nice deep breath in. Everybody take a nice deep breath in. Still feeling good, feeling relaxed. All the hypnosis will be gone, except for Cha-Cha. That'll still be your name while you're in the room. And everybody else, when you hear Mike Lee, you all just respond with, he's the man. And as you continue to go up from step three to step four, all the numbers are back. And the last one, you're right back into the room, feeling refreshed, feeling good, all the way up to the very top step, and you can all open your eyes. And again, my job up here is just to help people hypnotize themselves and get into self-hypnosis. And, you know, I rely on them to be the stars of the show, and they were very entertaining, and you made us all laugh tonight. I don't know, you can ask them, maybe they can tell you.
Why'd I have that? Who's Linda? Cha-cha.
So, all right, so everybody go ahead and stand up for a second. Go ahead and stand up. And again, you are all the stars of the show, so everybody just take a bow right where you're at and give them a huge round of applause. And my name was Mike Lee. He's the man. You can go ahead back down. Everybody else, congratulations on your senior year. Thanks for inviting me to your school. You were all awesome. And I'm not